Multiplication ratio is the increase in planting materials over what has been planted. For example, a cassava stem cutting when planted yields about 10 stem cuttings 12 months later. In contrast, a maize plant which yields a cob with about 300 seeds has a multiplication ratio of 1 to 300. Thus, cassava has a low multiplication ratio compared with maize. Rapid multiplication of planting materials helps to overcome the low ratio and overall yield of cassava production. Many stem cuttings are small stem pieces, each with one or more nodes, depending on the stem portion from which the cuttings are taken. Three types of mini stem cuttings can be produced from a cassava stem.
From here to here is the hardwood portion. From here to somewhere around here is the semi-hardwood portion. Then from here down to the tip is the tip shoot portion.
It is important to apply the right tools when preparing these cuttings.
When we want to make our cuttings, we need to use a very sharp object, either cutlass, shear, chainsaw, a handsaw, or a secateur. But for demonstration, we are going to use a secateur. These are the two nodes cuttings. You must cut very sharp. I think you can see the way I'm doing it. I think you can see it. There from the semi-hardwood portion, you cut. You can see. You can see the way I'm cutting. Very sharp. Then from the tip shoot portion, you can cut, you cut like this. Then you clip all the old leaves like this. You make sure you cut all the leaves. So we have the two nose cutting here. We have the one from the semi hardwood, which is the normal plant length, the normal stick length. Then we have the tip shoot.
Take care not to damage the axillary buds and place tip shoot in water immediately to prevent dehydration. The number of nodes on cutting is not fixed and depends on factors such as internodes length, stem diameter, plant age and weather conditions during and after planting. A cassava plant can produce 60 to 100 mini stem cuttings.
Before planting, we normally treat the material we are going to plant with a fungicide. The type of fungicide we normally use is Benlit. And we need a basket like this. So we have the materials inside. And again, we have water inside the bowl which we are going to apply the Benlit before the treatment commences. After cooking like this, we leave it to dry a bit, at least for the water, the fungicide to enter into the material before we now take it to the field to be planted.